We are back once again, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be time for the ESL ESCA Pro League here, and we've got Titan and Virtus Pro playing on Train, I believe, for a best of one game. What do you think, Samla? What's gonna happen here? It's going to be a crazy game. Titan, I mean, I don't know what's happening with Titan right now. Shox is calling every once in a while.
Well, that's the main thing, actually. Big shift up there. And this has been a main issue with Titan for quite some time, and what we really discovered again at the Major is just the fact that they've grown used to losing. And so the core of the group have spent so long losing that they've forgotten how to win. Existence in particular, you know, it's just like the 2 years now that they haven't been able to make it out of a major group, even though they've been favorites to do so, or at least, you know, make second seed. They should have been able to do that pretty handily. That just never really panned out for them. So Shox coming from Envy, along with Smiths, they're coming from a team where they're used to winning. They know how to win. They know how to get the job done. I'm not really surprised to see Shox decide it's time for me to take the reins here and see what I can do to maybe get us over that hump again and, you know, get us winning again.
I wonder. I mean, I can't recall there ever being a time where Shox was calling and being like the superstar carry, you know? So I'm just wondering if it's worth the sacrifice. I don't see him being the kind of player who can do both. So I am a bit worried, to be honest, about that particular aspect of it. I guess we'll see if things have improved here tonight. Titan going to be starting on the Terrorist side, Virtus Pro on the CT side here. And they've got armor on almost everyone on the VP side, except for Neo, who's taken one for the team. Snacks with a good early headshot. Shock's going to be gone, who's one of the big pistol players on Titan. That's a big shot down early on. Bailey hitting a shot, Pasha too. It's looking great. Bailey with a double headshot, and now down to RPK, drops the snacks, and that round is going to be gone instantly. Virtus Pro, I mean, just shutting it down.
Yeah, that's painful to watch. I mean, it was also painful to watch what VP did to Mouseports at SIVO in the finals, best of five finals. Mouseports never really got anything going. Virtus Pro just plowed them, wrecked them. And, well, it seems like VP have kind of maintained some of that form here, because that is one hell of a strong start in the pistol. No, nothing chaotic about it either. It looked like most of it was just very clean work on VP's side. So clearly they're warmed up, they're ready to go for this match, and well, it's going to come down to Titan now to make something happen. Seeing as how they're going to go for the force buy here. Look at this aggressive push from Bialy. Good on you, Titan. Don't let them get away with that. The shenanigans, they need to get punished.
That's one of those pushes that's great if they don't have armor, and especially head armor, but when they do, well, that Tech 9 versus the MP7 is definitely going to be a little bit better at that range, especially when there's three people behind them. So, yeah, I like the courage on Bialy there, but just the wrong time to do it.
Yeah. And no backup either from his teammate. You know, no possibility for a refrag or anything of the sort. So that's definitely a little frustrating there. Titan, they're just making some noise. That deep smoke is definitely wasting a little bit of time for them. They don't have any nades or anything of the sort, so they're kind of limited on their options. They kind of just have to group up and run in as a unit, and we see that still. Three guys at alley. Snacks takes the peek at Pop Dog. He doesn't spot RPK getting into position over there, so this could get a little tricky here for Virtus Pro. Titan, they've got the momentum now.
Smith with the kill. Taz in the corner takes one. A lot of damage to Scream as well, trying to see if he can do it. Taz does pick up a double, and they almost catch him. They will catch him, but not in time. Neo there to pick up a double kill of his own, long range as well with that MP7. It's going to work out here. Just barely, though, for Virtus Pro. Very expensive round. And Titan, this is one of those scenarios where you think, yeah, we did so much damage. Maybe we could follow up and win. Because if they win right now, they bounce back to a tied score and a 2-2, and then it would have all been worth it. Mm-hmm. This is the Envy approach, you know?
Yeah, just... This is actually Shoxy just being like, you know what, boys? Go for the bye. We did so much damage in the last round. We've got them right where we want, and we can totally do this. And they got real close last time, so we'll see if they can actually manage it this time here. No aggression, though, this time out of VP.
French Counter-Strike for you.
Mm-hmm. No holds barred. Straight for the jugular. Well, the main thing, though, is that VP, they're going to be like, well, okay, we can't actually just go for silly stuff. We might have to respect them just a little bit. Just a teensy-weensy, you know, little bit, Anders. A shred.
But this is where Train becomes such a fun map, in my opinion, is that if you respect them too much, you're going to give up that bomb side. And then once the bomb is down, things get very tricky if you're on the CT side. So they kind of have to stick around a little bit. They can't just be too passive either. That was a beautiful grenade from Pasha early on. Now he's looking to scout someone underneath the smoke here. It's just at the edge. He turns around. They're literally right behind him. Flashbang is going through. And Pasha, he's going to get... Oh, he gets a headshot. That's ridiculous. Trying to go for a second one too, but he's going to run out of bullets and ends up going down. That was so nuts. How does he hit that shot? Otherwise, right now we're in a 3v3, and they have the scout as well, but Scream all the way in the back lines here. Very hard for him to get out from behind the train. Oh, God.
We know what he can do with the scout as well. Or with the scout rifle. Just go back to the pistol, Scream. It'll end better. Don't do it, man. Yeah, Pasha with that sick headshot that just saved himself there. And he was right on the... I think what happened is that classic where he misses the shot... Or he because we saw Sean Gares do it as well not too long ago, where it's like they quickscope out of it or they swap out of it really quickly. So maybe they think that they got the shot, but they swap just a split second too fast and it cancels the shot out. Because he definitely spotted the man close. He was turning away to avoid that initial flash.
Yeah. Oh, no, that was a little bit interesting. Bit of a failed grenade over there, but still just trying to make their way in here. This time they do not have armor on the Titan side, so the initial risk they took by forcing in the last round, it could come back to haunt them a little bit here, as their economy early on is going to be weaker than it otherwise would have been. Still not got the bomb plant down in three rounds, and it looks like they won't get it in this round either.
Yeah, Taz, good discipline there. Not going for the full spray. Not necessary.
And oh, wait.
Yeah, passes on the hunt.
Oh, wait. No, shucks. Of all the people he could have stabbed.
Exactly. Okay, talking about what used to tilt get right, where, you know, you shoot him in the corpse. For Shoxi, that was a thing. He saw knifing is an ultimate sign of disrespect. Like, you just didn't do it ever. So Pasha shanking Shox, that's going to be a little bit of a tilt going on for Shox now. He's going to be frustrated about that.
I do think actually what tilts Shox more than himself getting knifed is watching his teammates try and knife other people. I think that's where he, like, really gets upset, you know. But I think he will be able to get back into it a little bit here. But, yeah, I think he's generally more enraged if he sees his own team try and do it.
Every little bit, right? Quite a few bullets going out here, but Taz keeps his cool. Doesn't let Titan know that he's waiting right around the corner here, around the box. And they're still hopping around Titan. They want to see if they can catch somebody. Nice nade, though, onto Taz. Follow-up flash. Can he actually get out of here? Can he get a kill out of this? Good flash, and it's Neo instead to dart forward and pick up one kill.
Taz not really doing a lot back here. I feel like once Neo came in to help out, Taz should have been a lot more active. Now he's in the back lines here. Somehow, he still hasn't died, which is a bit weird. Down to 5 health. Going to put up that Molotov, and I think that might have just exploded in there. Yeah, that was a bit too high. So, I'm actually a little bit disappointed in Taz there, because Neo's decision to come and help out meant they could have just tried to double up on that.
Yeah, a little bit of a lag there. But still, 3-on-3 situation. Titan, this is favorable for them. They still have quite a few nades to work with as well. So the options are there. Now it comes down to Shox making the right call. Basically figuring it out. And they're going to group up. It looks like they want to get onto the B site. They have a bit of better odds, perhaps, of getting the bomb plant here. So they want to see if they can't apply the pressure, make use of these nades.
Well, the problem is the time here. They need to get that bomb down, and Shox stays alive. If he doesn't go down, then Smith is going to have a... Smith is going to have a really hard time putting the bomb down. But now, Pasha, well, he's been spotted in the back lines here, going to take down Existence. And neither Shox nor Smith has a lot of health left, so they've got to stick around and make sure they don't get themselves killed right now. Pasha, not a lot of time to waste. He has to just run in here and try and look for the fight. He's going to almost get the kill on Shox. I thought that was actually a sure thing there, but does end up going down. So nice round from Titan finally. Good rotation back in. But if Shox doesn't win that first fight, then the whole round pretty falls apart.
Yeah, pretty surprising misses for Bialy and Pasha both. It looked like Bialy should have been able to at least pick up that first kill with the spray, but just a little bit of a lapse there for Virtus Pro. They still have so much money that they're able to go for a pretty serious full buy. Double op, shotgun on snacks, and a couple of rifles with a good nade count as well. So they're definitely not out of this round. It isn't going to get any easier here for Titan. And did they actually put both shotguns in the same spot as well? That is actually kind of scary.
Good grenade out there, and Taz missing pretty much all the bullets, but he's going to go for a second volley, running around the train here, making a lot of noise. Actually, it's going to be Bialy and Neo, and Taz helping out here. Great defense being put up right when Titan were looking to get their game going. They're going to get shut down and wrecked in that B-bomb site.
What do you do now
if you're Shox?
Well, you go and start taking some crazy fights, right? Because that's the only option that you really have. 58 seconds left on this clock as well. It's not like it's, you know, there's only 15 seconds left. He can go run away and save his AK. He might actually still try and do that. We might have a pretty long wait here, Anders.
Are you going to do this to a Shox?
He's just making as much use as, you know, the time as possible. Why not, I suppose? Maybe he catches somebody out of position. I mean, that's what he's hoping for right now. There is Neo waiting around on the A site still. So he could potentially get a backstab shot in. Does Neo realize this, though? Neo is looking, but wrong way. So Shoxi does manage to pick up the one.
That actually would be... I mean, that's already a big thing that he steals one of the AWPs. If he can make sure they don't pick it back up and don't find him here with 15 seconds. I mean, time well spent, I'd say.
Does he actually... Yeah, he's going to make this no problem. Because VP don't have the money to really go out and hunt for him either. And it wasn't Neo. My mistake. It was Pasha who was waiting on the A side. But still, regardless. The CT side win. That was a bit more expensive than they would have liked. Still keeping two players alive means that they'll get a decent enough buy out of this. Taz can full buy, no doubt about that. But now Titan,
We're saving AWP. It can lead to some pretty big rounds, but the problem is when you're on the terrace out of the train, it's so hard to find an opening unless they're going to give it to you. If it's different if you're on the CT side, because then you can be lucky and put it in the right position and then get one or two kills, but this is going to be a little bit tough. So Shox, smoke, Molotov out. Is he going to try and force the issue here? Smith has picked up the open scream. Has that Galil in hand. They're running for the fire here, and Snacks, easy pickoff. Wow, look at that. Triple kill for Snacks, and RPK gonna go down last. The Frenchies burned to a crisp and then followed up with it sprinkled with some bullets on top.
Yeah, I don't know if... I guess VP ordered some crepes Suzette this time.
Oh.
But, I mean, what was the point? You know, like going for the rush when you have an AWP, try and make the AWP work for you a little bit. Don't run through a Molotov with the AWP. Hey, that felt really desperate from Titan. And I don't know, they probably could have tried to change up the pace a little bit rather than just YOLOing in there and hoping to get something done. But that's the case, and now they're going to be on pistols. Pretty hard eco here for Titan. VP, now they get a chance to farm up that economy once again. Start getting a little bit of room to breathe. And they don't go aggressive once again. They decide to play it fairly safe here on VP's side. Knowing the state of the economy for Titan means they don't need to go rushing into him and throwing a rifle away. Just make sure that you're in position to deal with any kind of rush coming out of Titan.
Ooh, yeah, and I feel like any kind of rush that is going to be coming through right now, I mean, it's going to be mostly Glock, no armor. There's a limit to how excited I can be by that kind of rush. It's a good shot there. That was the only Glock that was, the only non-Glock on the team that was on RBK. Does do some damage to Snacks, but it's not going to be too easy. Actually, they don't check the corner and Shocks. Glock close range will do that. It's going to be Bayani with a double kill, leaving Existence alone. And in a 1v4, just shuffling around on that ladder, doing some dance moves, it almost seems like there. Ultimately, doesn't have the bomb, so just wasting our time. Go and die, Existence.
Yeah, right? Well, there you go. Snacks hunts him, and then, well, VP, man, they're really coming out ahead here. 7-1. They have so much room. And Snacks, man, 12-2-3 for him. He's certainly showing up. Whereas Smith's an RPK, I mean, it's nearly a James Bond for Smith's. It's not looking too pretty here for Titan, for the Frenchies. And well, just to give you guys some context on the standings in the league, I mean, Titan are still they're still right in the middle of the pack as far as their scoreline is concerned. 9 wins, 8 losses. If they were able to get an upset win versus Virtus Pro, this is a key win right here. If Titan could have picked this up, they still have a chance to just barely squeak by and maybe make it to the spot at the LAN. But if they lose this match to VP, it's going to be very tough for them to come back in the group. Whereas VP, kind of the same story for them. They're 6-9, so it's really, you know, all or nothing for VP. They need every single win, and they have to cross their fingers when it comes to the round difference at the end of this.
Smoke from Snacks to try and check it out. That's an interesting idea. I wonder if he can actually potentially get up behind that flashbang as well. I mean, it is Snacks. It's a big risk trying to play that aggressively. Smith's going to be crouching right into Neo's crosshairs, and Bayali waiting around the corner. Scream going to win that fight initially. But Pasha's there to leg Shocks once, and he's going to come through the smoke with a flashbang out as well. And Pasha, not a lot that he could have done. The bomb is dropped up there with 40 seconds, though. And Scream and Shocks very low on health. Going to have to try and see if they can make their way back. But look at how far apart they are. They can't possibly help each other out. Snacks is up here in the, what is this, like the break room? The TV lounge room? There's a radio playing. He's just having a grand old time right now.
It's a bit smoky in there as well. Just waiting for that match of poker. And somehow Scream pulls it off.
Where is that smoke coming from?
I was wondering myself. Hey, it's the break room, Anders. Guy's gonna be kicking back, having that cup of joe, taking a bit of a break.
I don't know what kind of breaks you're having, some of it. That's a bit much. Counter-terrorists
win. You know how it is, man. Long days.
Shucks and scream. I mean, they get to save the rifles. The rest of the team can't really buy, but they kind of have to. Just go for Tech 9 armor at this point. A lot of grenades, and then I try and like brute force the B bomb side, I would say. Mm-hmm. Just try and get the bomb down and hope that Shocks and Scream can stay alive for the afterplant and make that work.
Let's see. 7 rounds. And now they don't actually go full aggressive either. Molotov there is going to force Shocks to move. Shoxy! Down to 20 HP.
Smith's down to 0. all the pellets landed in his face.
it was really quick as well. That was a nice little shoulder peek there by Snacks. But Shoxy, man, that's scary stuff. Puts a shot through. Pasha's gonna miss. If only he knew that Shoxy only had 20 HP, he could just go at it with the pistol, but this works as well. Plays it safe, puts the smoke down, forces Titan to continue to just hope to get lucky. Oh, this HE. Somehow Shoxy survives. Down to 10 HP now. You just can't kill this Frenchman. I mean, he's a butterfly after all, and there's a Schmetterling. He can just, you know, he's just floating around. You just can't quite get that direct shot on him.
Shoxy certainly is beautiful like one as well. Mm-hmm. He's a very, very handsome man. Pasha looking to get a shot for the smoke here, but not going to see Shox just early enough. So somehow this round has actually turned on its head, and now we're 30 seconds into it. See if they can actually get that bomb down finally on the Titan side. Neo going to be able to kill there. Shox to go down, and the Polish team, they're fighting back now. Existence only with a pistol up there. Going to jump off. A little bit scary, but not going to find a way out.
So 9-1 to score. Titan in and just very awkward all over the place. Snacks gets domed as he tries to push into team main. Pasha unscopes when he has Shocks dead to rights. So, I mean, sometimes that's just the way it goes in the round, but they keep their cool VP. They carry on, and while Titan now, they go for the full buy, and Smith does have his AWP. So, Shoxy had it in the last round. Now Smith's the man rocking it. So let's see if he can actually find an angle to work with. It seems like he wants to take it over to the B side of things. See if he can catch Taz pushing aggressive. But again, VP are very consistent with that smoke, making sure that Titan are going to have to just wait before they can really try to take over Brown Halls. And it is important to make sure that you can run down the time wherever you can on the map. You don't want to give them full control, Titan, right off the bat. This actually allows for Neo to get up in position as well, to have that angle now in case Smith's or anybody tries to come around and peek from upper.
I can't really understand why Titan are so insistent on being as slow as they are right now. I don't think they have any rounds where they really try to be fast, except that one round where they took the AWP out for the fire at Pop Dog. But apart from that, they've been slow every round. And you can catch a lot of teams off guard by just pushing B. Just push B early on, they have 4 and A, you get some good grenades up, and that's it. Seems like Titan are just kind of overthinking the situation right now. 9-1 being the scoreline with about 38 seconds left. They're rushing in here. Snack's going to be the one kill on RPK in there. Smith's going down. Only got one kill, I think, so far in this game. And down to the remaining Titan players to bring it back. Nice turnaround there. Pasha going to get the headshot. And now Existence goes down to Neo. And that will be 10-1. Just, I mean, I guess we could credit them with saying these slow pushes. They do seem to all the time end up in like a 2v1 or something like that. But it's not enough. They're not winning those clutches.
Exactly. And that's what it boils down to sometimes, Anders, is whether you can actually land the shot. And that's what, and you have to have the confidence to be able to do that as well. So yes, the slow push is there, but then you do have to be willing sometimes to just, you know, get around that angle, get that headshot, start the ball rolling for your team and not slow down. If you slow down, then it gives time for VP to readjust their positions, communicate what they've seen, and well, that's what can happen there. Once they start having a little bit of time to breathe and communicate, they start locking down the rounds. VP Neo with the AWP gets into a better spot with that op, holding a longer line on the A site, and well, it isn't pretty. But there's the bait. Spots two players at least, VP. So Neo, now he knows, he gets that flash out there. It's not gonna be fast enough. He might be able to dunk this HE though.
It's a good idea. Gets the headshot on one. Neo still doing work down here. Taz, that was a mid-air catch on Shocks, and Bialy showing up as well. Grenade is gonna be raining in there, and Existence tacked up a bit. The follow-up Molotov just trying to deny the plant right now, but Bialy somehow ended up alone. versus Pro maybe a little bit too quick with the rotate, and considering the bomb hadn't even been planted, maybe they didn't need to charge in like they did. And that gave a break and an opening for Titan. Now they're 2 versus 1. Well, they are playing as Byalian because of the C connector. He can just rotate back and forth between the two bomb sites. There's a good shot on RPK. He jumps up existence. It's going to go down as well as a headshot and a triple kill here for Byalian. And one more round. Nicely played here from Byalian.
Yeah, heartbreaking loss there for Titan. They could have definitely had that going for them. Existence just trying to charge up onto that site to get the bomb plant, trusting in his teammate to make good use of that AWP. And sometimes, I mean, well, Byalian just, again, confidence. He knew exactly where to look, takes that shot, and just because the man had like 5 HP left as well, a single bullet from that M4 was enough to do the trick. It was whoever was going to land the bullet first, Anders. Byalian this time, he gets the job done. Smith's just going to flash his way through. He wants to get that aggression. So this is actually good now. That kind of just results in a wasted smoke by VP, because the whole point of that smoke is to try and buy time up here in Brown Halls. Now Smith has basically negated that.
Well, they need one good opening frag here in B, and they should be good to go. Neo, actually.
That's not good.
Falling off of the train, trying to make the jump over there. Flashbang goes in. Taz very close by, but RPK sees it coming. Gonna win the first fight there now. Neo alone in the bombsite with the AWP, trying to come up from behind the snacks, but he goes down. This is a great start right now for Titan. Might be able to finally pick up the second round in this first half here. Neo might be overrun as well, but oh, he gets the shot. That was to the edge as well, onto RPK. And Existence pushing closer, dropping by Ali. Neo and Pasha alone for the retake.
Well, Existence is holding up close to connector. Neo and Pasha, they're running out of time. They have a kit on Neo, so that'll shave 5 seconds off of this. Neo finds Scream. Pasha spots out the man Existence holding close to connector, but they still aren't on this site. Still two players alive here for Titan, and they're both playing from it, but that bomb is ticking down. Shox peeks out, removes Neo. It's a one-on-one. Smoke is there, but there's just not enough here. Pasha, he gets the final kill. He makes it as expensive as possible for Titan in the end. But it's just not going to be good enough as far as the round is concerned. Titan on the board with the second round. We're going into the 14th round of this half, Anders. And they only have two. That's not quite good enough for a T-side here on train.
No.
This isn't like 1.6 train or anything.
No, exactly. I mean, even early Global Offensive train was like very, yeah, very CT-sided, right? Times have changed. The fact that they lost everybody, Titan, I mean, it must feel just a bit frustrating to win a round and then be left for one guy with a Galil. And look at Snacks just charging up. Scream doesn't see it coming. He pre-fires the corner and takes down Existence. Dirty play from Snacks here. Puts up the smoke, but RPK is going to be charging through. This is some very weird Counter-Strike coming in here. Just, I don't know, not what we're used to seeing. 2-for-1 trade favoring Virtus Pro. So Shox, RPK, and Smiths are left, and I love the wallbang attempts from Neo, but sneaking through the sidewalk, Smiths, if he can get in here behind Taz and maybe kill Neo, that would be a good start here. He's gonna see it, and there's Neo going down. Taz might be next in line. Smiths opening up that bombsite single-handedly. Good job on him.
But VP, they're still so far away. Unless they can get a kill right now. Well, there you go. RPK is gone. Now if they can get a kill again. No, Smith doesn't peek, so Bialy's going to have to work for it a little bit. Somehow finds the angle. Perhaps spot Smith just as that smoke blooms. Fresh smoke goes up. Pasha holding down. He's counting on his teammate to keep him alive in this. Time is ticking. It sucks. He's not going to get the angle right. Insult to injury. He at least gets the kill at the end, but just not able to pull the trigger fast enough there. Definitely a heartbreaking finish to the half here for Titan. The fact that they couldn't pull through in the end.
Might have been a bit too much sound for him to hear the first defuse being tapped there. So maybe all he heard was like the smoke bloom and the shots being put through. Bit of an upsetting situation here. 12-2 in the 15th round coming up. And Titan, I mean, they've got a little bit here. It's not too bad. Virtus Pro don't have a lot of equipment either. Strange way to end the half, really.
Just VP, this time it kind of breaks their way, but they just still look so on point right now. Coming out of SIVO, you're wondering if perhaps that would fade a little bit in these best of one online matches, but no, they're putting their foot down. So Snacks again playing close to Pop Dog. This time Shoxi isn't there to watch the back either. So if Titan decide to execute before their man is in position, to make sure that flank count comes through. Snacks can just go rocketing up.
Oh no.
But it's not going to happen, and Taz has already picked up one kill.
And that was the bomb. Now it's dropped on the sidewalk, and look at everybody rotating in. They know where that bomb is. Existence going to go down as well. Shocks and Scream. They are low on health here. RPK dropping a little bit too, but it's all down to Taz now. 1v3. He's looking for the ace clutch right now, and he's being shot in the back as well. Oh, and Scream! What a way to end it. Takes down Shocks after he heroed the round. So now it's going to be 12-3 scoreline. Don't think VP are going to be feeling too sad about this one, though.
No.
Wasn't it just Independence Day in Poland? I think it was.
Ah.
So, maybe...
So playing with hangovers as well? Man, VP really are godlike.
Yeah. To be fair, having spent a few after parties with the VP team, I feel like they can handle themselves pretty well. I think I've challenged Bayali at least a couple of times to, like, you know, hey, let's do some shots, and I always come out on bottom of that game.
Yeah, dude, Bialy's actually a trooper, man. That guy.
He's like thin. He doesn't look like the type who can, you know, who could go toe to toe on that kind of thing.
Pack it away like that. Yeah.
I can't win that fight, man. It's really hard. I'm not ashamed to say though, man. He's just hardcore like that.
It's Pasha who's never shows up, but when he does, you're thinking, ah, Pasha, you never party, but yeah. Just when he shows up, he means it.
It's serious business. Second half is coming in now, and we'll see if VP could do what a lot of teams seem to struggle to do, is just to close out games. You know, right now, win the pistol round, you should be winning right away, but it's not always that easy. Smith's missing a lot of shots here. That's going to allow for a bomb plant almost for free here. VP not even taking a lot of damage. And now Titan, they're all retaking from the same angle. I'm not really liking this.
Yeah, they could. Long lines, and that's where the P2K and the USP can come to the fore, really. We see that happening now with Existence getting a headshot onto Taz. Shoxy making sure that Pasha can't hold that lane, but from the connector, Pasha will find one. Snacks gets a shank kill on Existence, and it's going to be down to Neo now to keep these guys from defusing. Kit, Smoke, whole kit and caboodle. No Molotov to buy more time this time, Neo. It is not going to work.
And that would have been it. If that Molotov had gone through, they probably win the round right there. I love it, Titan. I mean, we've seen this a couple of times before. The teams intentionally save that one smoke at the end to cancel out the Molotov, and it works just fine this time. So 12-4, and just a clutch smoke.
Clutch smoke.
I love it.
Thorough smoke.
More of that.
I mean, when it works. But that's also the issue, though, is that, you know, for CT, because they have that advantage of the one-shot headshot at any range, you take, like, Virtus Pro, they need to be pushing aggressively. They need to be getting up close where the Glocks are going to be dangerous. And, well, the fact that there were so many players there for Titan, it just doesn't seem like VP were able to put that pressure on quickly enough. Now it's just going to be a straight-up run out into the outside. They got the bomb plant last round, so VP were just hoping to get lucky and get another one here to just get a little bit more bonus money going into that first buy round. That's just not going to be the case. They pick up Scream, and that's it.
Well, decent start second half here. It is a CT-sided map. You know, if they can get back into like an 8-12 type scoreline here, I mean, not right away, but if they can win the crucial round in the fourth round, it's definitely possible.
Oh, a missed buy there. $1,200 wasted by a Scream going for a Bison. That's not good.
Yeah, not the best one-tap potential for the Bison if you're Scream. You could do it for a long time, though.
Yeah. That is actually pretty frustrating if you run into somebody who's actually good at using the Bison. Same thing as the P90. Alright, well.
What they need to reintroduce is the TMP from 1.6. Had the most ridiculous sound.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. 1.6 TMP. I wish they had that. It's not the source TMP, which is apparently horribly overpowered, but.
Shots. I just missed the source burst, man. For the FAMAS. I think it was sick. Yeah, man. Yeah, it was sick. I actually missed that a lot. Because you can actually use the FAMAS at long range. Now it just feels like your bullets disappear halfway there.
Yeah, I can't use the FAMAS myself either. Galil, somewhat. Not so much the FAMAS. Good opening this time, though. Existence going to be taking down Taz, and Shox is waiting somewhat close by the smoke here with the UMP in hand. Very important that he wins this initial fight, because otherwise they're going to get sandwiched in here. It is 2-1-1 split coming in, and Bialy is going to get the kill on Shock Screen now. You can see he's trying to cover so many angles. Bialy very low on health. It's going to end up going down. So Pasha, last man, goes down to RPK. It's a nice hold for Titan, but it is really scary when that push comes through, because if you lose just one of the fights, then the other people have to cover an additional angle.
Well, look at Scream, for example, right?
Yeah.
He's worried about Pockdog. He's trying to take the fight there, and then he realizes, wait, I'm exposed to Ali. Now he has to turn around. Luckily for him, the man pushing from Ali was already so low on HP. One bullet did the trick. But that can really turn into a nasty situation. It's very similar to Cobblestone B site, for example, if you're trying to defend on CT side. You lose one of those flanks, and then the guy's just going to get pinched in a crossfire. So, well, as far as Titan are concerned now, it's a little bit more straightforward for them here on the CT side. If there's anything that they need to work out on their T side, on the CT side, they can just rely on the aim. And they have quite a few good aimers on the team. Scream, RPK, Shox, even Existence sometimes. Do they actually succeed in getting the bomb plant here, though? That would be fantastic for VP. And it looks like Bialy's just barely going to make it there in time. Bonus 800 in the pocket. That's all VP wanted.
That grenade, I think, did more damage to Scream than anybody else, but he's still going to be surviving. You're right, though. Pretty good job. No armor, just regular pistols there on the Titan side, and they still get a bomb plant in. So 7-8, and that's what I said. If they win that crucial fourth round, then suddenly things look a little bit different. It's only a five-round gap here. This could work out for Titan.
Certainly, if they win this one right now, they still have money in the bank as well, because of how easy it's been for them so far at the beginning of this half. They've actually managed to get a reasonable bank to work with here, Titan. Means a little bit more room to maneuver with. And if VP win this next round, it doesn't mean that Titan lose the map outright. So now we have to see VP on their side. They've got the Molotovs, they've got the smokes. They have an AWP. This time it's on Neo, not Snacks. So that was one thing to note as well in the first buy round. Snacks was prioritized with the op. Interesting choice. I mean, he can op, but Neo is pretty much the main opper for the team now. So it's good to see that he has it here.
Bit of a grenade there, just to keep Shocks alert. Yeah, and Neo opening on train as well. I remember having seen him a couple of games in the past where he was very good at that. So
oh, Neo has the angle. Misses the shot though. That build up, that long build up of inching forward from Neo, and Smith put himself in the worst possible spot as well. And Neo misses a great opportunity to get the opening frag here for VP.
Well, they're going to go for a split. Look at this. Two Ivy, two Pop Dog, one out main. And they're getting shut down right now. Scream, Existence, and Shocks, all of them winning their fights. So that's two angles of a three-pronged attack gone without anybody from Titan even dying. Pretty good job.
Yeah, that's so frustrating now for VP. Neo's going to be kicking himself a little bit. He did go for the cool jump shot, basically, but Smith hits all two. Well, hits all three. Hits both of the shots, that is. Very well done there. Neo as well, though. I like that. That drop down was just like, surprise! Didn't work this time, though, Neo. Smith is definitely ready.
So now the gap is closing very fast here. And Virtus Pro, I mean, we started off this half by saying maybe they could close out this game quick and move on. That's obviously not happening, and Titan are now making a pretty good comeback here.
We got everything they need, Titan. Now we see a bit of an adjustment made here from VP. They want to try and get in, catch the defenders over by Ali as quickly as possible. Molotovs everywhere, though, and great flashes as well. Pasha full blind. He still comes back in time to see Shox. He's trying to push through, though, and that's going to be it. Now they have that initial frag, and Neo clicking away with the Tech-9 will find the kill on Scream as well. Man advantage for VP going into the bomb plant if they can get it.
The bomb is trapped in that corner over there. Smith and Existence are actually in a great position. Neo gonna go and pick it up here. Smith gets a kill on Bialy. They need to get that bomb out of the corner somehow. Smith, the smoke is definitely gonna help out. Neo holding right at the edge. Existence also gonna get a kill. So now it's back into a 2v2. And Neo barely winning that fight. Existence, he can't stop it. And that should be the plant here.
Existence. Bomb has been planted. He's actually managed to get around close to the bomb train. And then fortunately, he's got a man at his back now. Very slow push coming in from Pasha, who's at Ali. He's just holding to see if Existence is going to try and work his way back around through the back line. That's not going to be the case, though. Existence, he's running out of time. He's got that kit, so just a little bit more to work with. Hoping to draw somebody out into the open, but it's just not going to happen. Crossfire was established, and VP made very good use of it.
Yeah, and the Belgian player there trying to see if he could you know, use the smoke as a way to lure out one player so you can get the kill on him and then maybe, you know, turn it into a 1v1. But he didn't have a lot of time to play around with. It doesn't work out. That's VP now getting around him with a fairly basic and aggressive push into yard. No big setup, just run out there and take the fights. That's what I was trying to say. I wanted Titan to do on their half because right. they were going so slow and steady. And sometimes on train, it seems like you just have to be like, full YOLO.
No fear, only dreams. Shoxi once again roasting alive, down to 50 HP this time. Manages to get out of there a little bit faster. One fun thing, yeah. I was about to say, Smith, he's got his SCAR 20. He's going to get to use it at any point, though. That's that'll be fun to see. A little bit of a shock treatment here for VP if they decide to run into that. Quickly turn into a blender situation. A flash into alley. Shoxi under pressure. Molotov to force him back off that angle. So they're just trying to keep the pressure up here, VP. And they are going to start collapsing onto the A site. Once again, utter chaos. Screen taking two with him before he gets overwhelmed. Snacks with the double kill of his own, but it's still a man advantage here. And now a two-man advantage for Titan going into this retake.
And with that bomb down and out in the courtyard here, I mean, Pasha trying to see if he can make it work. Not going to happen. Titan win the round. Going to reset the VP economy. They also save both the auto sniper and the AWP. So now there's a very good chance that Titan can get really far back into this game.
Yeah, what do VP go for here?
I mean, in fact, if they don't get the bomb down, VP, they have two members. That's Pasha and Neo, I think. Look at 1,500 and 14, so yeah, 1,400, that's not a lot of money.
Well, they succeeded in getting the bomb plat last time on the B site, so I'd actually like to see Titan take that into account. Maybe try and set up the defense there, but instead, wow, Existence, look at this. Straight out through alley, he's managed to push, get a lot of information for his team, but this still doesn't exactly tell them where they're coming from.
You know what this is? It's the eco hunt.
Yeah, he just wants to pad his stats. Can you blame him, though?
Well, actually, he might have been heard running up here. So, yeah, they know. Because there is still a player in main, so they definitely know.
He's just pushing in now. He spots him in Brown Halls. So that's all the information he needs. He knows that two players are up there for Virtus Pro now. They're going to try and wrap back around on this VP. It looks like they want to try and go out from Pop Dog, and that's based off of what Snacks has come up with here.
Not again.
Save map twice. Shoxi gets knifed.
Oh, that's devastating. Existence doing a good job up here. Snacks. Still picking up the AWP somewhere down in A and trying to see if we could fight a couple of people in connector. Not going to be working out so well. And actually, they double jump. He gets Scream killed, though. And Neo, well, he's alone with the bomb, trying to push further here. Maybe looking to do some damage. He's going to go down, so Shock's getting stabbed. Titan's still winning around.
Yeah, but, you know, Shock's... His confidence.
He should buy like one of those things from Team Fortress.
Jesus, do you lose points when you get stabbed? Because Shoxi's got 10 points now on that scoreboard.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening.
All right, go ahead. What do you mean in Team Fortress?
In Team Fortress, like later on, you could buy like an addition for the sniper, like a shield on his back. So when spies try to backstab you, it would like fail initially.
Really?
Yeah, backstab protection. Yeah, you never tried that?
No.
It's a real thing. Not that it matters, because all spies were awful and they were very easy to kill even without that, but...
Well, because you just have the pyro running around.
Not even that.
Up.
The spy literally had an uncloak sound that apparently only me and a couple of friends were able to hear, but it was very, very easy. So we did the uncloak sound, just like, oh, someone's trying to kill me. I guess I'll just switch to my SMG and kill them. Spies were the most useless class in Team Fortress. That's what I'm trying to say. Scream, gonna get a good headshot in on Taz there by Ali with a refrag on Existence. Still looking great here, and Shock's picking up the AWP shot. Neo and Bialy trying to fight back, and that auto sniper wrecking them in the corner. And Titan, they're getting dangerously close right now. Versus Pro, where's the focus? Where's the determination? Where's the speed behind all of this?
Mm-hmm. That's the main one. Where is the speed?
They're tiptoeing around.
Lollygaggers.
Stop being such pussies. Run into a bomb site.
Those cats, I know, man. Seriously. It's not the time to groom yourselves. Y'all look good.
10th round.
Why am I even trying to save that? I don't even know, man. Like,
I'm losing my mind because we've been seeing two teams here on the terrorist side just, you know, tiptoeing about, not really doing it. This time they're going to go with a lot more speed. They do also run in before the smoke goes up, which makes it lives a little bit easier for Smiths, but after that smoke blooms, they can't really get the shots through. Bomb is going to go down. That grenade not going to stop it. And nice bomb plant here. If they do what they just did, except they don't run in before the smoke blooms, and they have rifles. That's what I want. Because Titan are doing the exact same thing every round that they've been doing for a long time. They have one guy holding B initially, four people in A, and it's only like that for a couple of, like, 10 seconds, and then they rotate one guy back into B. Virtus Pro played the exact same way. It's almost everybody plays train. So for a good 10, well, actually, you'll have to run. Maybe for a good, like, 5 or 4 seconds, there's only one person in B, and you can try and rush that guy. So, do it.
Do they have the info, though, Anders? Is it as obvious for them as it is for us? With the Eye of God on our side. Hey, look at this bird's eye view. This is a Spooderman view.
Spooderman. I didn't even know where that comes from. How did it happen?
4chan, I think.
Has to be a 4chan thing, right?
Everything of quality comes from there anyways.
It's true.
Well, I mean, VP haven't quite figured it out for themselves because they decided to slow it up once again, and it's just going to be a straight A execute this time. So, hoping to change things up. We'll see. They want to dodge that SCAR 20, it seems, but Existence up on the first train. Nicely done there by Snacks, and it's actually Neo to pick up the kill on Existence. Shoxi does strike out and take Bialy down. Neo, though, brings it back and takes out Scream, so it's all over the place. A 3-on-3. Still haven't dealt with the man in the back alley, though, but a smoke goes up just in time, and it is going to be a quad kill here for Neo. Can he pick up the ace? He's still alive, and he hits the shot. Ace for Neo. You can't do that every round, but still, that's a feel-good moment for VP. That puts him up on 14 rounds.
That seemed so determined from Neo. That was like the hold my beer moment and just watch me wreck this whole A bomb site on my own. Like, what just happened? How do you even do that? You're right, you can't. That's all. I mean, it's an amazing round, but in so many ways, it's also completely useless in the sense that you can't really just say, ah, let's do that last round, Neo. You just run in B or in A and just kill everybody.
Yeah, be a god.
He's like, I am but a man.
Well, Shox is up here, and I think Neo is playing down in main, trying to see if he get back out here. Oh, actually, Snacks are trying to play with the auto sniper. He's getting down quick. Shox not missing a frame there.
And well, again, VP in a bit of a pickle, struggling. They do have a bit of an in, though. If they can get through alley fast enough, this is going to put some pressure on Shoxi. You know, Shoxi realizes that. A little bit early on the flash. Bialy going for the spray. Not quite going to find it. And VP do manage to sneak their way through without taking any damage. But as I say it, Shoxi strikes again. Takes out Bialy. There's the third kill. Removes Taz. And it's going to be on Pasha now. 1v5. Finally avenges his fallen teammates. He takes out Smiths as well. Nearly going to get the third. But Existence puts an end to the party.
Wow. I mean, Shox got triggered pretty hard from that Neo Ace. He was just ready to pick it up himself. Mm-hmm. Pretty damn impressive, and that's going to make it 13-14. So in spite of a ridiculously one-sided first half favoring the Polish Virtus Pro team, now we're sort of, you know, back at roughly even odds. It might even be slightly favoring Titan at this point, considering that VP just have an awful economy, and they actually do kind of go for a force here.
No, they have to, right? Throw it all to the wind, because if they lose this round right now, VP, they're going to be in a very tight spot. Titan can get up onto match point. We'll see all 30 rounds here. So let's go. Once again, VP, though, slowing down that pace. And so they went for the A execute. Now it's time to go for the B execute. But Titan are in position. Smiths has got his SCAR 20 again. So they'll be able to get the smoke up on upper. Smoke should be going down on lower as well. This time they don't go before the smoke blooms. So no free kills for Smiths. Taz finds RPK, but Smiths does manage to take out Snacks.
Well, that bomb plan is a little bit delayed, but it's finally going to be going down by Ali pushing up with a C set and taking out Smith's Task, winning the one fight and trying to see if he can transfer it onto Existence there. They've got the man lead. Existence picking up a double, though, going to bring it back here by Ali, picking off Existence, and now it's down to Shox. He's been going ham the last couple of rounds. He's going to have to go big and clutch it for them. Otherwise, VP might be able to run away with this game here. Shox going to go down, and that'll be the round for Virtus Pro. Quick and aggressive and right in that B bomb site. Mm. I love it. Yeah. Are you hearing those train sounds in the background, by the way?
Yeah.
I have to say that none of these trains are moving. There's the one outside of T-Spawn here that is sort of moving around, but it's going very slowly. I feel like that...
You can hear the truck loading right now, too. You didn't hear, like, the truck backing up?
Beep, yeah, I did.
Beep.
There's just a lot of traffic noises on this map for a map where it has almost no moving trains. It would be a lot more fun if one of these trains was moving. Like, it would just come, like barreling through at, like, 100, you know, kilometers an hour. Someone would be trying to pound the bomb, and oh, he got killed by the train. It's too bad.
Too bad, right? Come on, you know that train goes by at X second in the round.
I can see that happening.
Yeah, you know, they did that for the overpass
major,
now, right?
They're going to win the major. Oh, no, they're going to win the major after all. Cancelled by the train.
Thank you, Valve Devs.
Someone should make an edited version of Train. It'd be hilarious to try and play on. It's 15 to 13 right now. Still a chance for overtime here for Titan. They're playing on the more favorite side. They got a little bit of rifles here as well. Not too many grenades left, but they could just win that initial fight. And VP are back to a very slow start, which hasn't really been working at all for them so far. Scream and Shock's gonna be able to kill each, but it's returned by Snacks and Taz. So back in a 3v3, they're trying to get onto that bomb site. Quick Shock's gonna go down. RPK finally refragging one, but they're getting close in here. And where's the backup? Smith's finally coming up. And I think that was down from Pop Dog. Bomb out in the open, and Snacks trying to pre-fire that corner. A little bit scary, looking for an opening.
For a second there, when the X-ray got flipped off, I thought he got that kill on RPK. He will find it in the end. So a 1v1 clutch now on the table for Snacks. Definitely one of the best players on VP to have in this kind of scenario, in this situation. With 20 seconds left, he's going to make that mad dash, try and pick up that bomb. Doesn't quite know where this man is playing from, though. He's wasting valuable time. Down to 15 seconds now. Not going to have any time for the fake plants now. He's just going to have to commit to sticking that bomb plant when it comes down to it. Catches the oh, what?!
I don't know. That spray control, triple kill for Snacks, and VP are going to win the game after a bit of a long struggle, really, for them. I don't know. That just happened.
It's just like a brain freeze, you know, where it just, like, sinks in, and you kind of just have to sit there and go like, and then...
you know how to cancel brain freezes?
All right, let's hear your... Right, okay, go ahead.
You have a method, too?
Yeah.
It's like... I want to hear your. I feel like this is some prejudice. I feel like your method is going to be dumber than mine. I don't know if that's like
press your tongue to the roof of your mouth really hard.
Okay, Dan. Actually, that is something you can do without looking stupid. Mine looks a lot.
Okay, mine works, so what do you got?
Mine works instantly. So if you
flip your head upside down like that.
Exactly. Like if you just do like this, like tilt your head to the side all the way. So yeah, literally.
So you know my method for getting rid of hiccups? It's actually really stupid.
There is none.
No. 100%, guaranteed, 100%, you heard it here. Going full Moses on this one. You take a glass of water, and this is where you start looking really dumb, because you have to bend over, like full bend over, get your head down below your waistline, right? And then try and drink that glass of water. But it works, 100% of the time, it works. You get rid of those hiccups like that.
I'm gonna do that.
Of course, you might get a shower too at the same time.
Yeah, water's gonna come out my nose. Plus,
but it works.
That has to be just 100% placebo. There's no reason why that would work.
I don't know, Anders, but it works, so placebo or not.
Next time I get the hiccups, I'll try and record it. I'll see if I can make this work.
I'm not getting the hiccups around you now. I'm just going to...
Yeah, I'll be following you around with a glass of water.
What's that behind your back, Anders?
Get ready.
All right, well, regarding the match, coming back to the match...
I don't know. I mean,
I think I was just a little shocked that Smith's decided to push out. He could have just waited a Pop Dog. And try to play it that way, but once he saw that bomb, I don't know why he decided to push. The only way that Snacks would have been able to win the situation.
He heard him running around, right? So I mean, I think all the footsteps, maybe like those coconut horse sounds. There, he felt like something's definitely up. But I mean,
you know the reason why they had to go for the coconut things, which is obviously one of like the biggest and almost awesome jokes ever in film history, right? Where they run behind, it's because they didn't actually have the budget for horses.
They couldn't do that.
When they realized, you know, when everything stacked up, they're like, wait, guys, we can't actually afford to get horses. What can we do?
Actually, I mean,
guy was like, coconuts, obviously.
Just because I'm very old and soon to be much older, obviously. Mm-hmm. There's something that's actually missing a lot from like the Source community that was very, very prevalent in Half-Life 1. It's like the whole modding community is just like, it's not gone, but it's like been completely handicapped for some reason. That's a real shame. So you said horses, so I thought someone could definitely do like a horse, you know, where you're like riding on the back of horses and shooting each other. It'd be a great mod. I would play that mod.
This is like some Gary's mod stuff right now.
Well, yeah, so Gary's mod has like become the mod where people just build mods out of that. Mm-hmm. But like in Half-Life 1, there was even like a website dedicated to just having like lists of mods, like really weird Half-Life mods. I played like the weirdest Half-Life mods. There was one mod where you were a pirate and instead of walking, you'd lie on the ground and your character would roll. So you just roll everywhere, and it's just very. There's been some very weird mods like that, but they were amazing. I mean, I had so much fun.
How did you aim? Did you like?
I can't remember if you could. It was just like a really weird mod. And there's one where you throw snowballs at each other, and paintball mod as well. It's like all kinds of really cool mods like that.
Paintball one I've played.
Some of them blew up, like Pirates, Vikings, and Knights was a great mod. Mm. Natural Selection came out of Half-Life 1. There's been some really big mods like that.
Was a different game.
Well, yeah. just to skip away from the mods that are fun. I mean, you guys, I hope there are modders out there still willing to mod for Source. It's so much fun. But if you've missed anything, like this great game that we just had, then go and check out the Score Esports. Also download on your iOS or Android phone, and you can follow up on everything that's going on in this league and other leagues too, and also read articles and everything else. Definitely a good resource for that. We're going to continue soon with our next game here. It's about 5 minutes away. Mm-hmm. Should be coming with two great games for you guys this evening. Both of them with Mouse Sports. One of them against Fnatic. One of them against... Who is it VP? I think it's Mouse VP list, if I'm not mistaken.
Tell you that in just a shake.
Yeah, Mouse VP, Mouse Fnatic. Perfect. So that's it. Coming up in just about 5 minutes. Stay with us and we'll be right back.